Hello，
Hello, this is our first, second podcast.
this is our second podcast, and we have just finished watching
Dragon
Dragon
Inn,
Inn,
by King Hu.
which is a 1967 film.
Okay, let's have
Okay,
a
brief
brief summary.
summary.
The Emperor's first eunuch Zhao, right, has actually like defeated General Yue, his political opponent. So the but then his General Yue's children are just like exiled out of China, but then the eunuch wants to kill them all. Yeah, so he's like going around looking for the children and trying to kill them. But this the Dragon Gate Inn's innkeeper, right, is Wu, right, is actually one of the General Yu's like lieutenants. So he actually summoned like this very skilled swordsman called Xiao to help them. So this whole film is about them trying to defeat the eunuch. And most of the like action kind of happened in the Dragon Gate Inn, and hence the title.
We'll first talk about
The shots and transitions. They have rather interesting like cuts and transitions and like camera movement going on, right?
There's a lot of variety. So for the starting scene, right, of the first 10 minutes of the film, we already like see tracking shots.
A lot of tracking
A lot of
shots.
tracking shots. And like whenever the for how they kill the people shit, what am I
Yeah,
supposed to
talking
say?
about tracking first. It's as if it's like a one long take, so like the tracking actually follows every action. Then there's also like panning, zooming to action. Basically the camera is just following the whole action going on. Then like the tracking actually shows like new information. Yeah, so it's as if everything is placed nicely. So that when you track, right, like something new will, like will come out.
Start, there's a variety of cuts, right? During like scenes where the people are killed, so they don't explicitly show you how the final blow was delivered. They just like there's the sword movement, then after that, the next cut is the person is dead already. Most of the scenes are like that.
And like even though they use a lot of cuts for killing scenes, which are quite interesting, a bit like how Hitchcock did in like Psycho.
Oh,
Like
for
you don't
the showering
see
scene, is
you
it?
don't see the knife actually going through the person in real time, but you see like a montage of
Different cuts, ah.
stabbing, like shadows and all that. And then you just the final scene is just the person dead. A lot of them are like that. So because there are like so much variety in the shots, right, it kind of keeps the film going.
As in, it's very action-packed. So, okay, final showdown.
The final showdown is like really very interesting, seriously, because you get like all the different cuts in. There's one part where they actually showed like they use a lot of tracking for like the fighting scenes, right? So it's really interesting to see them doing it real time. Like it doesn't cut to the somersault. Like it doesn't cut to a new.
New scene that
Yeah,
you're talking
like you
about.
know in. In more modern films, like they actually use a lot of cuts to cover up like the flaws in like those flying shots or that kind of things, right? But they actually did everything in like this one whole fighting sequence where he fought a lot of those villains at one go. It's like one, it's just a tracking shot, and then he just keeps going in front, like
So
just
it's
keeps
just
killing, moving forward and going, So it keeps tracking on. It's a bit like
one
Old
long
Boy,
thing.
right?
Old boy's
The
fighting
that very
scene.
famous
The
scene, Old
corridor
Boy.
scene.
It's very choreographed. That's what very that's that's what is so interesting about this whole wuxia, yeah, genre is wuxia, this, yeah, martial arts film. And the final, we still haven't talked about final
trailer.
Yeah, final trailer is interesting.
Because the fight is so long and none of them died.
They use a lot of...
they try to attempt like when the person is jumping, then they will cut. Like when the person is flying.
Yeah, they still do the same thing for like previously we have said they use like jump cuts for the shots, right?
Scenes.
For killing scenes, yeah. Right? But for then the final showdown, they finally have this flying scene going on, which is very typical of wuxia, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, they.
Where
they
the person jump.
Yeah,
and
the
fly.
Person just jump, but you don't see them really flying across the screen. It's just.
Yeah.
Like a very tight shot of it, then it cuts to the action already.
Yeah.
Especially that one scene where the eunuch actually tried to. The eunuch, like.
Try to
claw,
scratch.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Scratch the cell's forehead, yeah.
Yeah, that
so
was
we
a
actually
very
see
fast
him,
scene.
We actually see him, like, just jumping like a tiger.
Yeah,
and then,
stretching out his hands.
Yeah, and then the next shot was Xiao with his. With his forehead, like, wounded already. Yeah. Things like that.
So actually the movement is like very fast and you won't get to actually see it.
In a way it's, yeah. And there's this very interesting shot of the throwing of the bowl of noodles. That was the first jump cut that like really caught us. Because it's really very interesting. Like how he just threw
a bowl of mutton
noodles. And then
noodles.
It just sort of jump cuts to the
noodle landing on the table.
Yeah, still in like, you know, in its place. It's kind of like stop motion. Yeah.
Speaking of stop motion, remind me of the coin scene when he threw the coin, then everything just landed and it just went into.
Yeah,
that
was a very obvious stop motion. Yeah, he was throwing like coins to pay the innkeeper. And then, yeah, the next shot was, like, the coin box with coins appearing. Which is kind of like, you know, it just appeared magically.
Yeah.
And, yeah, interesting.
Okay, now we can talk about sound. Yeah, there's a lot of sound being used, so...
It's kind of like a
Chinese opera.
Yeah. With all the... Like, every movement they make, there will be this sound effect, like... Dun, dun,
dun, dun, dun.
Yeah, all the gongs and stuff like
that. Likewise, they also use a lot of Foley sounds.
Foley sounds.
Oh, Foley sounds.
Yeah.
Right. What do you mean? As in, like, some parts, it doesn't make sense.
I think they dub over the whole movie.
Yeah.
So, that's why a lot of Foley sounds going on. That's why some of the... Like, you realise that most of the scenes where they are actually, like, running about, right, is the same sound.
Footsteps,
yeah. It's the same sound used over and over again.
Yeah.
And then their dialogue is also kind of upfront. Like, there's not much of a distance, right? Yeah. Then the most interesting sound design part is where, at the
final showdown. They keep reusing the same
there's
sound.
There's this part where
the
eunuch kind of goes a bit, like, his vision is kind of blurred. Because I think he has some illness, right?
Yeah, he has asthma, right? Or something like that. Was
it because
mentioned?
No.
Oh, okay.
But he has something going on. Yeah.
So you keep hearing this...
this whirring, buzzing sound. Yeah. So every time the sound comes on, then we'll know that, he's encountering that again. So sound design is actually pretty important in this action-packed movie.
Yeah, to tell us what is like happening to the characters at that point of time.
Yeah. It's kind of like, basically this pattern of like sound, I mean this, how to say, this trope, like the sound design all is like carry on to other wuxia films, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, a lot of them actually use the style that King Hu used in Dragon Gate Inn, which is why this film is quite a influential work. Yeah.
It's a classic.
Yeah, it's a classic.